Okay, before we really get rolling here though, let's go grab some data. I'm going to go over to the courses folder to 120, week 6, control A. Actually, you know what? I'll just pop out. I'm going to right click, say copy that whole folder. Then I'm going to navigate to my working directory and paste it in there. And then I'd like to open up ArcMap. And I'm going to save this as a new map. So navigate to my current directory. Under week 6, I'm going to call this the week 6 map. And then I'm going to do a little housekeeping. I want to make my home folder the, let's see, that's not where I want to be. I want to be under here. Now, 120, week 6. Apply, OK, save, and then remember, I think you have to close and then open it up again, which I don't know why they have a design like that, but hey, I'm not going to complain. And say, OK, I'd like to open week 6, and now at this point, my home is set. So with the housekeeping settled, let's go after this first task. It's more of a teaching moment than a real kind of necessary part of a workflow. But I just want to make sure that you understand the... sorry, I haven't had enough really wine and butter this morning to be able to affect the French accent, so...
Plate carré.
There it is. So... to be able to teach you this, I want to talk a little bit about the datum and the graticule. And so here I'm going to do this in Arc. To set this up, I'm going to go over to properties of the layers. And I'm going to, let's see, I'm going to pick a projected coordinate system. And just bear with me for a second. I'm going to go under World. And I'm going to pick... vertical perspective and say okay, and then I'm going to grab the TISO polygon and drop that on, and you should get this beach ball kind of effect. I just want to make it red to kind of okay. So what we have here are we're looking at the model of the spheroid, or it's actually an ellipsoid because it's slightly flattened, and we've put these circles on this model, and the circles are all the same size and shape. It's just when we're looking kind of dead on to the ball here, we see the circles with very little distortion, and as we move away from this kind of dead on spot, we start to kind of take an oblique view of the circles, so we're kind of looking at them at an angle, which is why their size and their shape changes. And to really be able to kind of help visualize this, I want to add, I'm going to go to properties and add a grid. And I want to add a new grid. And I'm going to accept that. 10 by 10 is great. I'm going to uncheck these because I just want this to be a little bit cleaner. And I'm going to same, you know, also to clean this up, I'm going to double click on that. Say no color, and then finish, and say OK. And it's not going to really look like we did much, but we're in data view right now. I'd like you to click over to layout view. And at this point, you should have a new set of toolbars that either become kind of colored in, or they may appear someplace on your map. And if, in which case, you can just dock them on the menu bar. And so these differ from these because these change the view of the data. They're just basically, if you grab the zoom in and click on the map, you're going to wind up changing the scale, right? Whereas these just change the how close you're looking at this piece of paper, right? The layout view is this gives you a view of the paper that you would eventually print out if you were making a map layout. And by grabbing the magnifying glass on the paper, you can then zoom in to the page. And so what you'll see is that we've just added a graticule to the datum, or to a model of the spheroid, or the ellipsoid, I should say. So datum, spheroid, and ellipsoid are not purely analogous, but they're very closely related. So if we zoomed out, what you have here are lines of latitude. You have the equator, and the lines of latitude are parallel, moving poleward. So you have 0 being the equator, and then we chose to display these lines every 10 degrees. And that helps us see that lines of latitude are parallel going towards the pole, north and south of the equator. We also have these other lines beginning with this one. Do you know the name of this special line? It is the line of zero longitude, which is generally called the prime meridian. And the thing that differs, the way that lines of longitude differ than lines of latitude, is they not only go vertical compared to the horizontal alignment of latitude, but they converge on the pole, right? So these are perfect kind of slices of the Earth, the lines of latitude, but lines of longitude all converge and meet at the two poles. Okay, so what we've just done is created a nice model of the datum and the graticule. The datum being the model that we are draping our graticule onto. And so it gives us our kind of base for measurement. And the graticule being the system of latitude and longitude that we use to identify locations. And we have the Tissot, they're called Tissot indicatrix, or you can just think of them as Tissot's circles. Tissot was a fellow who came up with this handy way of visualizing distortion on projections. The circles are all the same size and the same shape, but when they are represented on a flat map, the shapes become distorted. They are a handy way of visualizing distortion that comes from flattening representations of the datum or ellipsoid or spheroid. Okay, so now what I'd like to do is get back to this French word. So now what I'd like to do is first make this smaller. So I just grabbed the black arrow, clicked on this, and I'm going to just turn this into half size, click on the globe to go to full extent, and now I'd like to copy this whole data frame, right? I right-clicked on it and said copy, and then go over to edit and say paste, and now I'm going to drag the one on top of the and pull it below the other, and then I'm going to right-click on this and go to properties at the bottom, and I'm going to call this the plate carry. And the coordinate system I'd like to import from the Tissot because I know that the Tissot is in the geographic coordinate system, the World Geodetic System 1984. And if I say OK and then zoom out to full extent by clicking the globe, I now have a plate carré. That's as good as I get. And so what do you think? What's going on here? I'm going to grab the magnifying glass and cruise in. And what you see is along the equator, we have circles that all look pretty much the same. But as we move northward or southward, as we move poleward, we begin to see distortion. We get a change in the shape, and we also get a change in the area of these features. And the reason being that we're taking the lines of longitude that converge on the pole and we're splaying them apart, right? Because the lines of longitude should all converge on one point, but we're representing the lines of longitude on a perfect grid. And what that does is distorts the size and the shape of features as you move poleward. So if we just look a little deeper into this, what we'll see is that we are representing the datum. In this case, it's an ellipsoid. And the reason why I know it's an ellipsoid, even though it says spheroid, is because it has a flattening ratio. And so what that means is that it's a little bit wider than it is tall. And these are the kind of dimensions of the two axes of the ellipsoid, one being a little bit longer than the other. And the other thing that we know is that the units are in degrees, the angular unit, which is typical of the graticule. And then we have the prime meridian, which is Greenwich, which means that this zero mark should line up with Greenwich, England, because of some history. So the main problem of representing the graticule on a grid, as we're doing in the Plate Carree, is that you preserve neither the shape or the area of geographic features. And that means that you're going to induce error in any measurement that you do on this type of representation. Now, it's worth noting that it's worth kind of being aware of this for a couple of reasons, but perhaps one of the most important is that it's a very common way for geographic data to be delivered. And in some ways, it's kind of a raster legacy, because it's quite convenient to have the pixel address of your raster data sets be the latitude and longitude of the graticule. So you'll have a lot of data that gets delivered in a geographic coordinate system, which is why one of the first things you'll have to do is project that data. The other thing I'd like to say is the cartographer's error here was not simply representing the world on a Plate Carree. And they chose a projection for this map, it just was not a projection that preserved distance. So some things I'd like to kind of be able to answer, or I'd like for you to be able to answer, is first, what projection are they using, and how can you recognize that? And secondly, how can you create a projection that will allow you to draw circles on a map that do preserve distance? Okay.